Hello, hello, hello. Hi! How is everyone tonight? So yes, once again, another stream. Of course, we have TwitchCon coming up this weekend. We have, well, I have a very special B612 event, which will be involve more spaceships. We had Google Science thingy yesterday, which was cool. Yeah, and KSP won more community awards at the Unite. I guess it's a conference. I'm not really clear on that, but yes, you know, congratulations and thanks to everyone that voted, because you have made the game, you know, more respected. It's great. I'll be able to tell people this week. We're doing a special thing promoting, I don't know, Kerbal Space Program for Science. So hey, being able to point out that it is an award-winning game this week is once again awesome. So, I've no idea what I'm going to do, right? It needs more dank memes. No, it does not need any more dank memes. No dank memes. Yeah, you know what? Somebody was saying, hey, why don't you try doing an oblique wing aircraft? I don't know if you know what an oblique wing aircraft is, but it is an aircraft where the wings are oblique, obviously. opinions on Universe Sandbox, get it. It's great, you'll have lots of stuff to do with it. I mean, you know, it's got a lot of cool things going on, so totally check it out, whatever. Okay, let's do that. Let's flip this thing around. Actually, no, let's put two engines on the back of this thing, right? Yeah, let's give it some real power. Replicate, though that's actually a fun thing to try. We could try and drop a spacecraft onto the sun, which is harder than you think. That's what I'm looking for, is the a rototron, so that you can have an oblique variable geometry wing thing. Why? Something is wrong with these textures here. I've never fixed this. I've no idea what that is. Support cradles, cameras. Here's a rototron. Is that the big one? That's the tiny one. That's kind of big. Is there anything smaller when it comes to rototrons? I don't think so. So, okay. So the idea is that you have wings attached to this and they can go in any direction. So I guess the option will be to go to here and then find... I'm going to find like a square wing section and hopefully I can attach that in the middle. No, I can't. Okay. So we'll not do that. We'll do that. Yes, we'll do two wings just like that. Mirror them. And then we'll attach bigger wings. Hot Black Desiato. Yes, Hot Black Desiato. Hands up, who knows who Hot Black Desiato is? Or can you explain the best way to listen to his music? Okay, you can guess that he's a musician. Although I hear that he's currently spending a year dead for tax reasons. Of course, that was at the restaurant at the end of the universe. And, you know, with the restaurant at the end of the universe, time is rather strange. There, that's what we shall do. We'll do that. Flip this around. There we go. Okay, that's kind of looking interesting. Might need to scale these up, right? A sundiver! Yes, indeed, we are talking about a sundiver. Let's put whiplash on this thing. There we go. And we're going to have to figure out how to put some air intakes on this. Now I think about it, do we have any awesome air intakes? I guess I'm going to have to be stuck with the radial intakes, because all these things make complete sense. I could attempt an Osprey. That wasn't a hovercraft. That was called a tri-fan. Circular intakes, pre-coolers, what are my best options? Because the radial intakes are just terrible, but you know what, I'm just going to have to do it. Okay, structural intake this thing to death, just to make sure we've got enough air. That's looking kind of interesting. Tail fin! Tail fin, tail fin, tail fin. So anybody actually going to TwitchCon? I'm just curious, because of course I'm going to be there. since it's like a block from my office. There's, you know, why would I not go to that? I'm just curious if there's anybody that's not actually a Twitch streamer who's likely to go, or if it's just gonna be full of self-absorbed people that think they're important because they stream on Twitch. And I say this as a self-absorbed person who realizes that he's not any more important than anyone else because he streams on Twitch. I really like to try to think of myself as quite an average person. Okay, let's stick some winglets on the front here as well. I've no idea what I'm doing. How bad could this be? Well, you know what, actually, what we should do, we should... what I'm going to do, now I think about it, is... can I extend this just a touch? Kerbal fans. I put all my streams on YouTube, yes. Because Twitch is practically useless for me in terms of, like, view numbers. So, Twitch is... You know, it's there, but it's not exactly important to me. The reason I use Twitch is because YouTube doesn't work in Germany. YouTube streaming doesn't work in Germany. If they fix that, then I might be out of here. Or maybe not. I don't know. There we go. Nice! Okay. We'll do this. This will totally... You know, with these control surfaces, this is very likely to fall apart as soon as I try flying it anywhere. Oh, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna add a little bit of... Pardon me. Oh, dear. Has space and aeronautics always been a passion of... No, what's always been a passion of me is... wanting to be in Star Wars. That's really what it is. Okay, so I'm gonna grab this and move it over the center of mass. Oh, wait, it already is over the center of mass. I'm gonna move it forward just a bit. Oh, so we need wings at the back as well. That's a good point. Wings, wings, wings. So yeah, NASA investigated the idea of the oblique wing. The idea was this wing would rotate to adjust angle of attack. And I just want to see if I can make this thing fly. It is probably not going to fly. It's probably incredibly unstable. And what I think I'm going to do, actually, on second thoughts, thinking about this... I want to stick these on the outside here, okay. Stick these and rotate them around like that. There we go. And then we'll just raise the whole thing upwards, right? So that it just clears this. But doesn't really work. I wonder if the voxel thing actually works. Maybe I should put a cross-plane trail... tailplane thing here. Let's try that. Oh no, let's not. Okay, never mind. Let's put a horizontal stabilizer on here, of course, for stability reasons. Oh yeah, let's see if I can do that. Nice! So yeah, I was at the Google Global Science Fair yesterday, meeting all sorts of people who were so smart that I felt like a dummy compared to them. And then there was this guy called Veritasium, who I said hi to, and that was about it. He didn't recognize me, but, you know, I think given more time, he might say, oh, I know Kerbal Space Program, but he was obviously very busy being a very busy presenter and trying to corral all the people that were actually really important. You know, that's what he was there for. That's what he was being paid for. Or maybe not getting paid, but that's why he was there. Okay. Do, 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 do. Okay. Let's see how this works. Right, we're not adjusting the angle of attack. We're adjusting the sweep of the wing, right? So the cross... The thing about wings is that the... amount, basically how the angle of this to the incoming airstream is very important in determining the drag. So in theory I'll be able to rotate this and the drag will be diminished, right? What was the stream called when I there's a lot of different games where I start playing, a lot of streams where I start playing Kerbal but end up playing Space Fighter games, because I have a lot of Space Fighter games. I played one a couple of weeks ago, and oh, action group, no actions available. That's interesting. Infernal Robotics, there we go. So, here we go, we can adjust the wing. Ooh, that's going to be too fast. I'm going to slow this down a little. Right? There. So we can adjust this in flight. I'm going to rotate this back to zero. And then we're going to see if this actually flies. So, 5, throttle to 100%, engine ignite. And you know what's going to happen is, of course, these wheels are going to cause the thing to wobble. Yes. Getting things off the runway can be hard. That's why I did a quick save just before that. The plan is we're trying to build a flying oblique wing system, right? So I'm going to disable stability control and see if this will work a little better. Bring this up. It still does this. Yeah. Okay, revert to space plane hangar. Okay, so we need these copied. Let's bring them forwards to here. And let's get rid of this. And then I'm just like, you know what, I suspect, no, you know, these are so hard to tell if these things are lined up correctly. I think they're lined up correctly, but you know, the game needs a way to point out that these things are aligned or not, as the case may be. You see, that's lined up correctly. Okay. And then I'm going to move these downwards. Downwards. Gear placement is something I have never quite figured out. I don't know what magic I'm missing. I certainly, you know, figure out. I just can't quite figure out why some of the stuff works and other stuff doesn't. Oh, okay, let's try this again. Throttle, 100%. See if this thing will hold straight. Okay, that's a little better. And then we'll try and get it to the air. Okay, stability control enabled. Let's throttle back just a bit. Gear in. Okay, so we have this thing flying. Let me just check camera shake here. Camera wobble. Yeah, turn camera wobble off. Apply, accept. Camera wobble. Oh, that is something hateful sometimes. Let's try turning. Okay, look, the wing is holding on there. That's pretty good. Okay, so now what I want to do is see if we can fly fast. So I'm going to bring it up to altitude. Whoa. Might have some issues with stability here. Throttle those engines up. We'll get to like 1 kilometer, maybe. So Kerbal Space Program does, it supports occlusion of radiators and things like that, but there's it's not perfect thermal model, right? Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is try rotating this wing. Are we ready? 0.1. Are we ready? So the idea is you would adjust this into the wing, into the airstream, and whoa! Do you see how that snapped? The idea being that in this configuration, it's now presenting less of a wing, so it should have less drag. But I don't know how well that is going to work. But it does still fly. Let's try doing that a little more, huh? I should probably disable these. I wonder, disable. Yeah, these are all going off now. Okay, good. I like it. Oh man, that's pretty funny. You see, that is quite a cool right turn mode. Watch this, let's see if it does it again. Right, we're gonna hold it in a straight line. It's gonna go supersonic, and then at some point, it's gonna snap like a crazy thing. Okay, Mach 1! This is going way too fast. Did somebody break off there? Oh look, now we're going faster. Whoa, there it goes. And you see, look how fast. Look, that is like the fastest right turn there. Did you see that? We've accidentally built like an aircraft that can make an incredibly fast right turn. This is stock aero, I think. I don't have Ferrum Aerospace installed. Just gonna rotate this back to normal. So let's see this in a straight line, see if it can fly as fast, right? So we're gonna try and keep it about 3 kilometers. We've zeroed out our angle, and we'll see how stable this thing is, okay? 4, okay, so actually doesn't appear to be making it any faster. In fact, it appears to be far more stable in this configuration. Well, so much for that plan. Now we're catching fire. This does turn in a really... No, you can't really place struts to stop the wing bending relative to the aircraft. That's the problem. Come on, hold yourself still. Man, this thing is insane. I'm just gonna turn off stability control here, because I'm worried that it might be affecting things. Okay, so now we've rotated it to this orientation. It should be faster, right? Because we're hitting the angles into the wing or something. Did somebody see that I pulled 60 G's in that turn there? Oh, wow, we've hit some real altitude here. This is certainly an interesting design, I have to say. Probably not... Yeah, but you know what? 15G for a combat advantage? Like, would you take it if your life depended on it? Yeah, I think we're going to have to zero this thing out again. Or maybe if I move the wing node back a little, we'll be better. It's turning all the way around. It does kind of remind me of the space surfboard. You know what, I think I'm going to get rid of the control surfaces on this wing. That's the first thing I'm going to do. So let's bring this back to the space plane hangar. Okay. So yeah, let's minimize this again. Let's get rid of the wings on the front. Let's get rid of the control surfaces, because those really shouldn't be on there, right? And let's move this thing backwards just a touch. Grab this. There we go. And I'm going to move it inside just a little. Right. So now at least it is closer to the wing or whatever. NASA actually built something like that, or at least was investigating this. I'm not sure if they built it, but I remember it was a concept. So let's call it Oblique. Obliquity. Let's call it Obliquity. Whatever. I don't know how to spell it. Okay. Yes, you. So, if you hit things like, if you crash and things like that, people have survived hundreds of G's of impact. So it's not that unrealistic. And when you're strapped down or underwater or stuff, you can handle a whole lot more. There we go. Nice. I do really like this tailplane, by the way, that I've come up with. See this? That kind of looks like something you would find on a Minmatar destroyer or something. Okay, let's bring up the infernal robotics again. We'll put it in a flat line. I'm gonna throttle down just a bit, right? About 50% thrust. Have I ever built a mech? No, but I should try doing it, right? Okay. Let's see, we're hitting about 800. I kind of want to get level. And then I want to see if adjusting the wing will make it fly faster. Not enough rust. Yeah, maybe. Or actually, if you look at it, it could look like the rear of a Hulk. You know, an ore mining barge. There has been a new update to Rogue System. I have installed it. I have not yet played it. This thing is still accelerating. I gotta throttle down a bit. How about 1/3 thrust? Okay. Otherwise, this thing is just gonna catch fire. No, touching the nose down just a little. Okay, let's try rolling this into position. 0.2. Okay. Are we ready to see how this affects our flight? Will it make us go faster? Or will it make us spin out of control? There we go. Yeah, so actually we experience more drag in that orientation. So much for NASA. Yeah, so if I roll this back, it'll probably start to speed up again. Let's see if that'll happen. Oh, no, it's slowing down. Okay. 501. I want to find, like, a nice level flight so we can measure its speed. So we're slowing down. Let's try spin rotating this. Okay, so now we've got it to a pretty high oblique angle. And it yet does not affect our drag. NASA, I'm sorry, you guys think you're smart, but this just does not work in Kerbal Space Program. So I don't know what you are thinking. What I really like is that, you see, as it turns, the whole thing flexes. So it actually, when you pull up, it seems to be extra powerful in this orientation. Let's try landing this sucker, of course, because that's important, right? And we are in orbital mode. Let's return to zero orientation. I'm not going to try it with far. That would require me to reload and everything. That takes time. Well, yeah, but that would... So if you had two wings going, that would just be a regular variable geometry wing system. The idea was that it was better or something. The stock wings used to have a preferred orientation, but after I highlighted that stupidity, I believe Harvester made a point of fixing it. Okay. Where's the bait? I can't see my landing site because of these darn clouds. I have to descend below the cloud layer so I can see what I'm looking for. Oh man, look at this thing. It's going way too fast. It does look pretty good for the turning, look. Where's the G-forces? G-forces. Oh, 36 Gs I hit at some point. And this is a pretty calm flight, I have to say. Yeah, okay. We should be able to land this, right? Of course, I need air brakes. You think it needs rockets on the wings? Well, we could try doing that. We could try building an actual rocket helicopter. Why no Star Maid? Because, you know, I'm not very good at Star Maid. I could fire up Star Maid, but I have not played it in a long time. I do really like this tailplane. This, like, totally looks cool. This aircraft would probably fly without it. Is 64-bit support? Yes, 64-bit Unity support is coming largely because of the console versions of Kerbal Space Program, right? Let's make it clear that the console devs have done a great service in helping Kerbal Space Program get into 64-bit on Windows without strange bugs that I experience. Okay. Hopefully this thing will glide fine. Icklums says, Scott, hello! He misspelled hello if he's saying it to me, because of course I spell it with a U, right? I have no idea how it's going to run on a Wii U, but I'm going to say once again, the Wii U, the latest iPads are as powerful as a Wii U. Despite number of people who disagree, like some people were afraid claiming that, well, you know, my desktop processor needs a big heatsink and therefore your little, you know, thing blocked onto a case that is made of aluminium clearly can't work. Yeah, never mind. Okay, let's try landing this. I wish I had brakes. Come on. Ah, there we go! Totally landed it. And I might need to just turn a little and get on the runway. Yeah, there we go. I don't know. I cannot comment on the quality of Apple versus Snapdragon, so let's not even get into that. Okay, let's go back to the Space Center. Mm-hmm. Use SRBs pointing backwards for brakes. Yes, we could do that. Mm-hmm. Nailed it. Yes, indeed. I think this could be a really good aircraft, actually. I like the high wing on it. Maybe we should put, like, I don't know, maybe I should figure something to do. Okay. I think the game has crashed. It has crashed. Oh, yeah. It has crashed. Yes. And this is why we want things like Unity 1.1. I have used Separatrons to get into orbit, but no, I have not got as far. Yep. Start it with far. Let's see if we can bring up the Comprehensive Kerbal Archive Network. Let's bring far into this. Ferrum Aerospace. New mod install, apply. I just uninstall, reinstall, uninstall, reinstall. Oh, error! No, look, it looks like it's already installed or conflicts with another mod. You know what? Okay, actually, let me take a look. Maybe I've put this stuff somewhere. Oh yeah, I copied that in there. Because I probably wanted to just get rid of it temporarily for some bugs, but I'll paste that back in there. And this is flying again! So what was I gonna do? A mod there. That was actually an idea I had. Okay, never mind. So, what I want to do is take off this wing completely. And we'll say this as Obliquity 2. I want to see how well it flies without the wing at all. Right? No, we don't need air brakes. Why would I need air brakes? Let's see if I can get this thing flying on just those tiny little wings. Are we ready? Come on, we gotta... There we go! Yeah, body lift. Hey! Sweet, huh? It is literally like a rocket. Let's see how fast it turns. That's pretty good, actually. It's like pulling a steady 4 or 5 G's just on body lift. Total lifting... I mean, there's those tiny wings for control. Oh, but it is a lifting body. Like, most of the force is actually coming from this body. I think there's a way to view that. Yeah, I wonder how stable it is, actually. Now, I wonder what its stall speed is like. I really kind of like this. Okay. It's just like a missile. There's something really kind of cool about this. Okay, let's actually get it. I don't know, what shall I do? Let's go for altitude here, right? Let's pull it up into an altitude record, okay? Come on, get some speed going on here. F12, look at the forces on this thing. Okay, let's try turning it. Watch as it turns and falls apart. Oh my god, it's like, look at that serious amount of force that's being generated by the body there. It's still pulling like 4 G's, right? Yeah, well, what do they say? The F-15, like, there was a famous case where the F-15 lost most of one wing and was still able to make it back to base. It was an Israeli F-15, I believe. Could be wrong on that. It does look like a sea urchin. It's pretty awesome. Okay, let's do a flyby of the tower. Nice! Look, I exceeded 30 G's there. Right? 30 G's is pretty respectable for something that has no lifting body or anything. Okay. Well, no, an A-10, I'm not sure an A-10 can lose a whole wing, but it can certainly lose half of its tailplane, because all of its tailplane stuff is replicated, right? Okay, let's go into a climb and see what kind of altitude we can get this up to. Yeah, yeah. Negative, Ghost Rider, that pattern is full. Okay, wait a second. Oh, here's my beer here. By the way, Joseph Brau Vienna, right? It's Trader Joe's. So the F-15 has a lot more thrust than the A-10, right? The A-10 is... Ooh, this thing is going to disintegrate in this kind of heat. How high do you think it's going to go? I'm just going to pull into a vertical climb now. Because I want altitude. 51 kilometers! Come on, a little higher. Just a little higher! Oh! No, there we go. It's pretty impressive. Uh-oh. I can hear the kitties have managed to get into the HVAC again. So they're running around up there. Yeah, the A-10 was a very specific type of aircraft, right? The F-15 was much more generic. The funny thing was, the F-15, if I remember correctly, was built... It was originally intended to be like the counter to the Soviet... Was it MiG-35 or whatever? The one that was like incredibly fast, right? They you know, it turned out that it was built super cheaply, but it could go very fast in a straight line, and it had very had terrible endurance and everything. But the threat that the F-15 was built to counter was simply imagined in the minds of analysts. It was a MiG-25. Look how far away this thing is. Yeah, you know what? What we should do is try putting like a sat. I wonder if my satellite station is up there. We could try making an air launch things. Oh, right. It was built super cheaply, right? But the analysts were all like, "Well, we know the Soviets have developed all sorts of stuff for dealing with titanium and, you know, all sorts of other fancy metals." But in fact, they were using it with steel. Yeah, it was simply it couldn't do more than like 5G or something. So it could not turn. Play Minecraft? I don't even know if my Minecraft is up to date. No, I don't have Minecraft installed here. But I do have StarMade. I'm sure we could find StarMade. StarMade, there it is, there. Okay, let's see if I can get out of this dive and bring it back to base here. Oh man, my nose is just itchy! Okay, let's go back down. Play DCS. I don't know, are you talking about... I don't have it installed. Oh, did you... I thought I had... What is it called now? It can't be called DCS, because DCS finds nothing. Okay, here we go. So I'm going to try to pull out of this dive. I'm going to turn hard to slow myself down. That's the first thing. Oh yeah, I've still got engines on. Probably shouldn't want to turn those. So, you saw that Megabot got, the MiG-25 was to deal with strategic bombers. They wanted a super fast plane that could get up there. DCS, why doesn't it show up? I thought I tried typing digital and I tried typing whatever. Let me get out of this dive. Okay. I'm having some serious trouble pulling out of this dive here. These control surfaces are not responding. I'm pulling back as hard. Oh, there we go. Oh my god. Oh, that was scary. Oh, wow. Wow, wow. Okay. So I gotta turn this thing around. I thought I was so doomed there. I was not pulling out of that. And then it just started to snap at about 2 kilometers up. Wow, that was a hard pull up. I was so convinced I was going to be a lawn dart. Have I ever played Besiege? Yes, I played. I have played Besiege, yes. Okay, let me see where I am. Yeah, that's it. I'm going to actually get some altitude, because altitude will help with speed. Yeah, look, here's all sorts of things I have. I'll scroll through my entire Steam list as I'm flying here. Arma, got all that stuff. Back to the Future, Bioshock, Black Mesa, Bridge, Commandos, Counter-Strike. Okay, what is it? Yeah, there's no digital anything here. How about World? World. I know I had the P-51. They must. It's not called DCS. But. No. Okay. I have no idea what's going on with that. I'm sure I have it somewhere. Yeah, I would love to see The Martian, but I'm not important. Playing Bioshock, I actually probably don't have it installed, right? Do I have it installed? Where is it? Borderlands. Bioshock 2. I don't have Bioshock Infinite. How come I've got Bioshock 2 installed but not Bioshock Infinite? I've heard that the Bioshock Infinite is far superior. I have Microsoft Flight Simulator X. Yeah, I don't... What is DCS under these days? Because I know I bought it. Infinite, really? Yeah, I own the DLC. Then let me check the store. Search the store. DCS. DCS World. I like how I'm at 1/3 thrust and I'm going at almost Mach 3 and catching on fire. See all. Yeah, you see, I own the Mustang, but I guess I've never actually installed it. That's funny. Well, I'm not going to install it tonight, unfortunately. Because I just have a I'm a big fan of things with the Merlin engine. Truthfully, that's all it is. I'm gonna have to throttle back even more. Look at this thing. Dungeon crawl stone soup. Yeah, that would be kind of cool. We have Mirror's Edge, Osmos, Penumbra, Plague Inc. I've never played this. Should probably try it at some time. Proteus, Psychonauts, Receiver, which I really like. Rise of Flight. I wish I could had time to play that. That is another. That's a game with where the things crash all the time. The only aircraft to ever achieve missile. I don't know. I know that a pilot of a Lightning demonstrated an attack run on a U-2, right, which flies at the same altitude as an SR-71. They had to do like a climb, basically a hard climb, and then as they were at altitude, they performed the intercept. Okay. If anything, I would go back and I'd play some more Alien Isolation, because I started playing that earlier. Look, I have Secret of the Magic Crystal, because Sky installed that. Yes, I have things like that. Space Giraffe, one of my favorites. Spirits of Xanadu. I get sent that game and I never played it. Maybe I should try playing it, but it does have an update. Let me go to my downloads. Downloads. Sure, download it now. Why not? Okay, where's the base there? It's over there. This thing is really cool because it can just keep... It doesn't need anything on it. I like it. It just has a ton of extra thrust at low altitude. Oh, man. There's something really quite beautiful about this. Have I got Sonic All-Star Racing? I'm not sure. Fractured Space. I think I want to play a little bit of Alien Isolation, but I'm actually really tired. Because I have a very busy week. So on Thursday, there's like Twitch pre-party stuff, and I'm meeting a bunch of cool people that like to support Killer Asteroids. And then there's TwitchCon, and then there's more stuff. There's stuff. There's just a lot of stuff. Let's do try flying over the mountains here. I can't believe this thing is flying. Like, I do have System Shock too. I've never had the time to play it either. I think I'm going to play Alien Isolation, though. Library games. Alien Isolation. There it is there. Okay. Let's just... I like how I can't see the mountains correctly. This is going to kill me, I bet you. We're just going to try flying through the mountains that are hidden by clouds, because flying an aircraft without wings isn't dangerous enough. Okay, now let's see if I can get super close to this wall here. Okay, well, I didn't see anything there. Let's throttle up again. Get myself out of here. Oh, let's perform a low altitude attack run on the base. That's what we'll do. Let's get super low here. Trying to find the shadow so I can actually get some clues to my altitude. No. Oh, there it is there. There's my shadow. Now I can see my shadow. I can fly this like a pro. Mach 1. At but a tidy altitude with no wings. This is just a standard day in the life here. I'm going to lower my landing gear, maybe. traveling at Mach 1 with the landing gear down. I don't always travel at low altitude at Mach 1, but when I do, I put my landing gear down just in case I touch the ground. yes. Okay. Yeah, EVE Online, there is no such thing as a safe region. PvP can happen anywhere and everywhere. And that's the way I like it. Okay, window capture. Okay. Nope, it's not picking it up. It's not picking it up yet. Because... Yes. Thank you. Oh, da, 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 da. Okay, so I'm gonna just play a little more. I'm just gonna continue my playthrough. It says press A, but I guess I can use the controller. Look, I have keys. Play game. I don't like that going up doesn't work. Continue game. I don't know what is beeping there, but it's very frustrating. Burn Jita is a thing because every now and then everybody likes to get together to show the kids what's going on. Oh, what is beeping here? It's nothing I know of. I'm gonna have to... Okay. So this is how... I guess the controller. I want to try playing it with the controller. Oh, this is too hard. Screw this. Yeah, that's much better. Emergency, please wait. Oh, okay. You know what? I'm gonna unplug... this. Maybe that's the thing that's beeping. Nope, that's not the thing that's beeping. Let's unplug this. No, it's not my phone. My phone is sitting here completely not plugged in because you know what? It's an iPhone. It's a 6. So therefore, it has a battery that lasts for ages. No, I unplugged the flight stick and then it started still making noises. Okay, where are we? We still have to unlock this. Apparently not. Find a way to restore power to the shutter. Let's sign in here and see what Sylvester Link says. Personal share. Oh. Personal 0340. Good to know. That's a code. Oh, no. Resume. Cue to go back. Goodbye from Sigsom. Oh, well. Everything's going bad. Kill the power! Get back here now!
Harris, Turner, get back here now. We have a track somewhere in engineering. Lock the terminal down, kill the power, and don't forget your reports. Make them thorough. We're gonna need our paperwork to be bulletproof when this shit's over. Wait's up.
Wait's out. Restore power to departures. Ah, there we go. Power comes online. Oh, quick! Quick! Wait! Wait! I knew that was gonna happen. No! Oh, darn. Wait for me! Take them all. So much for that. Well, that's where I came in from, right? Enter passcode. 0340. We have some scrap. Obviously, we have some scrap because we just crashed a space plane, right? Okay, great. How do I pick this up? It's flashing. Doesn't want to actually do anything. Collect the bonding agent. And a sensor. Thank you. So I have can find the crafting menu. You want me to change the Twitch title? God, you guys Oh god, you guys are so hung up on changing the Twitch title. It's like, oh, it says the wrong thing. Okay. I'll change the Twitch title. Isolated. I'll do alien isolation. There, and then update. There, I've clicked update, right? If it doesn't update now, then it's Twitch's fault, right? Okay. So, oh, we get some other stuff here. Let's take them all. So, wait, do I have a medkit? Left mouse button to build. So I could actually build. Wait a second. This, and this. Look, I have a medkit. Yay! Click here to craft the item. Yes, the aliens do all sorts of things. Okay, so now I need to figure out. I guess I can go through this door now. Oh, hey! It's customs and security. And they have a problem with their lighting here. You know what? I'm going to put on both ears. And yeah, just check out. I've been killed by aliens and stuff before. Because I had the ears on the wrong side. It was like, it's coming from my right! I shall go to the left! Didn't work. Okay, nothing here. Nothing there. Oh, hey, what a beautiful sight, huh?
What the hell happened here?
Well, clearly Vista got released and people were mad and there was a riot. This is Windows Vista doing obviously. Man. Oh man, big hole here. That does look kind of structural. I'm not sure if structural failures like that in a space station are good. This life for rent! That's obviously someone advertising selling their body. By the hour, obviously. Okay. I wonder if I can get over that. Obviously not. That's clearly something to stop me getting in there, so the game is working like that. Changing the title crashed my Twitch app. That's because Twitch is not that good sometimes. Okay, well, video phones are down, so I can't Skype anyone. I need an ion torch to open this, apparently. I don't have an ion torch, do I? Yeah, this used to be Sevastopol Station. Now, obviously named after Sevastopol in Russia, but there's a place in California called Sebastopol, which was actually named by... Oh, there's my spaceship! Hey! Hey! Hey!
I'm here. I'm right here. We're late.
Hey! Hey! Come on! Oh! Oh! Why are you closing the shutters? You foolish thing. Yeah, it's supposed to like get people freaked out, but it doesn't really work for me. Cause I'm not the kind to get freaked out. Oh, so you're running a Windows Phone version of Twitch. You have my condolences on that front. Okay. The music is excellent, I have to say. Sound effects on this are completely marvelous. You know what, in fact, hold on. Just gonna turn the sound up because you need to hear the sound. Should I speak louder or quieter? Should I be quiet, Scott? Should I be quiet, sexy Scott? Or should I be quiet, sexy Amy? Yeah, I can't really do that, obviously. Now, we need help. Well, if you need help with Kerbal's space program, then you're in luck. Okay. Oh, flare. Oh, there's something. Oh, can we get power back to the... power back to this? I totally want to play that. Air hockey? That's the business. Okay. I really like her Apple Watch, like, it's from a different generation. Cool. Run around Rex. All I've got is a flare and a med kit. Okay. Just want to see, is there anything else I do? Oh, tab brings me this. That's archive. Personnel log. Oh, look. A fielding. That's cool. I hadn't seen all these before. I'd never looked at these things. Highlight entry. These are people clearly are missing. Ha. Z Watson. Well, so much for that. And then this is the map. Okay. Okay, now what? Oh, there's a door open here. Oh, wait! Hey, did I see somebody? Hey! Oh, man. It's just running away.
Marshal Waits finally called a public meeting to address the rumors that have been circulating on Sevastopol. But instead of the answers we wanted, he continued to be evasive, and after only a few minutes, he and his team were pelted by projectiles from an angry crowd. A gun was fired, there was panic, and now Waits and what's left of his team are forcibly ejecting us from the terminal. Feels like we're on our own now.
Well, that doesn't sound too good. But I have to say, I hope we can find the person responsible for this work of art, because it is rather magical. I'm wondering if that's their attempt to render the new inhabitant, the newcomer to the station. Okay, that's that. Let's try this. Oh, man. Let's log into the super high-tech Sevastoblink system. Zoe, I'm sorry, we won't need you to come in next week. As you know, the store's been in trouble. Oh dear. Okay, to all spaceflight employees, it must be made clear there are currently no scheduled flight nor ships available. What is Apollo? What is Apollo? It is the central AI that monitors and provides guidance for all the Seeks on working Joes. Great. Oh, I keep pushing the wrong button. Well, that's not very useful. We have one of these, though. So I'll save my game. Because why not? Yes, I'm going to overwrite my game save. Oh! Aha! Air vent time! This is where I'm going to get totally killed by an alien, right? Nothing that way. Nothing that way. Something this way? I'm totally expecting an alien to just come out and jump at me. Yep. That's okay, it's just the space station falling apart. I'm used to it. I fly Kerbal Space Program, right? Space station's falling apart? They're totally par for the course. Ah, okay. Well, somebody set up some more barriers.
This whole damn place is falling apart.
Yep. You know who built it? I'm pretty sure Sean's cannery was involved. Uh-huh. Nice. We We have our usual thingy up there. I wonder if there's a way to get into that. Oh, we might have to try and get in that. How do you get over that? Let's try this. I guess I could run a little. There's no jump, right? Oh, there's an on button to get it to move out the way. Yes, great. Collect some scrap. And that does not sound good. Yes, it is. It is a
imagine a world where jumping has been outlawed.
Yeah. or maybe it's like a reimagining of a white man can't jump, right? Where it's like a racial thing as well. Where if you're not of the chosen race, you're not allowed to jump. Oh, that, what was that? Is that something in here? Nah, thought that would be a bit of something to pick up. And that's just a case of stuff. See, I'm totally not the kind of person to get scared by games like this. It doesn't matter how they the scientific explanation for how gravity works in the Aliens universe. It just does, because it was cheaper to film it with gravity. Uh-oh. Well, I'm guessing this isn't Thanksgiving dinner. Trust no one. But if you truly do trust no one, don't use that as your computer password. Test card. Okay. No, I'm just press R to activate. Oh no, I didn't mean to do that. Crap. Okay. Well, I've just wasted one of my flares. Well, that's good. The flare makes it harder for me to see anything. Oh, here's the thing. Let's do this. So I what button was she using to push that thing? Oh, hey! Is this the only place through? Have we get any more loot? Loot is what I'm here for. Oh, no, this is more of the same. Somebody has been reading anime. Sexy anime, by the looks of things. I need an ion torch. Okay, yeah. I think this is really going to ruin my stealth capabilities if I have to walk around like this. Plasma torch. Lots of noisy bits. The noisy bits are, of course, supposed to make me scared or something. Let's go back over this way. Oh, Hey! Hello! Oh, sorry, did I stand on you? Well, you're not gonna complain, are you? Let me do a dance on you. Dancing on the graves! Okay. And then there's this. Okay. Oh, here's a thing.
Nurse, this is Turner. I found the last
power. It's gotta be the exit up there.
Well, but it's off now. Just fitting the last security brace. Come find me when you've shut yours down, then we can get the hell out of here. Jesus, man, I'm hearing noises everywhere. Every creaking. Just hurry the fuck up, will you?
He used bad words there. I like how you slow down a little when you walk over dead bodies. Because, you know, obviously that's something that needs to be simulated correctly. It remains to be seen whether Star Citizen will in fact emulate this behavior, or simulate this behavior correctly. Ooh, bad words. If you're a kid that's not supposed to see sweary words, don't see those. And did he? Where are they now? Dig it, dish it, dirt it. Yeah, okay. Looters will pay. Okay. More stuff here. Fashionable desk lamp from the era. Oh, chess game. Let's see. I wonder whose move it is. It's really hard to see from this angle. There's not a really strong position there by the looks of things. Hold on. Sorry, I'm a game player. You're just kind of looking at games. I can't really see. Is that a queen? I guess that's a queen, yeah. Yeah, it's pretty early game here. Oh, look. Let's take a look in the personal storage. Oh, that's to hide. Nah, I don't need to hide right now. Hmm. The average Joe calendar. That's really darn creepy. It's obviously a magnetic chess set. I am actually a terrible chess player, or rather, I'm an okay chess player, but there anybody that has actually played chess is way better than me, right? Oh! Clearly, somebody had an accident. Okay, stuff going on here.
Rurs, it's Turner. Gotta deal with that wasted asshole again. This time he nearly wrecked the door with a maintenance jack. Guess he figures it's safe here. Wants to lock himself in. Screw him. We got too much to worry about without babysitting drunks. Anyway, I threw him in the evidence lockup. Let the son of a bitch sleep it off.
Okay. I need a maintenance jack to unlock that door. Coffee? Aha. Ooh.
Oh, fuck.
Hey! Well, that didn't work too well on him, but I do think that that thing in his hand is flashing, so therefore it's important. So I guess I need to figure out how to get in there. Oh, somebody else had an accident. Clearly too scary for some people. Ah, yes, it's one of those. Let's bring some music. Video games! Ooh, little spherical jigsaw puzzle in the evidence locker. How interesting. Okay, well, guess it's time to get in here. Let's just sneak along. Oh, I thought it would be going in there, but I guess not. You can ask questions, but I'm not going to be very good at answering questions because I'm kind of, you know, obviously supposed to be getting scared of this. Oh no, where is the alien? Oh, look. That's not good. Oh, look. A dead body and a recorder.
Hello, I want to make a complaint to the highest authority, okay? My name is Zachary Watson. That's Jackson. You get that?
I think I need this more than you do.
My complaint is this. Fucking marshals. They should be protecting us. It's their job. Something's on this station with us and no one knows what it is. No one fucking knows. They put braces on the doors. Lockdown. You know, like to keep something out. I'm fucking terrified.
Okay, so now we can start wandering around those doors that were previously locked. What am I hearing? Sounds like an audiobook. I forgot to pick up the ID tag. Okay, there's an ID tag that I'm supposed to pick up. Let's see if I can find it. Oh yeah, ID tag. Great, that's useful. Okay, so now I guess I can open this, right? Crank. It is very interesting. You need a very specific tool to open those when it looks like you could have a whole bunch of generic tools. Okay, invoices, compound B, tape recorder.
Interview subject. Heist. Did I say that right? Heist? Look. If you can't even tell me your name, we're gonna be here a hell of a long time. I just wanna know about your boss. He's got you all into a lot of trouble. Someone's gonna be accountable. I'm gonna make damn sure someone's accountable. No? Tough guy, huh? Turner, turn off the tape.
Uh-oh.
Maybe our friend here is just shy.
Yeah. How did that work out? Okay. Let's go this way. Ooh, that sounded like something moving. Now, if I... there was some control panel here. I wonder if I can use the key card. No, obviously not. Ooh! Sparky thing. A lot of sparky things. Nope, nobody... it would be really freaky if I came back and then the chess pieces had moved. That would be scary. Oh yeah, let's just save my game again. yes. Oh yeah, that's the one already. Oh, you get terrible beer and you've been playing cards as well. Okay. Okay, so we're now back in Sevastopol Station. What else are we looking for? Oh, we have this door here! Wait. Yeah, I guess this is the door. I can use this door now, right? Uh-oh! I guess we're going for a cutscene. Oh no, it's a person with a...
still.
Okay. Okay.
Now, turn around.
Oh yes, it's this guy. He looks like me.
I'm Ripley.
Where'd you come from? Ripley!
Off-station. A ship.
There's no ships here!
There are now.
Well, that's good news. Because things are not so good here. Something blew just now. Rocked this whole place.
I saw it.
But lady, that's the least of our problems.
Yeah?
Yeah. Something's on this station. Something you wouldn't believe.
Like what?
A killer. You get it?
Okay. What's your name?
Axel.
Axel? That's not a very Scottish name.
Two colleagues. EVA. We got separated by the blast. Can you help me find them?
Why?
Because you seem to know your way around.
No, I mean, why? What's in it for me?
A place on the ship.
How do I know I can trust you?
You can't.
I need to find comms. I need to contact my ship.
Yes.
This is your lucky day.
I think it's interesting that he has time to, like...
Seeks and comms is in the Systex Spire. It's quite a distance, but we can get to a transit through the freight area. But watch yourself. We can get into all sorts of trouble there, okay?
Ooh, we can get into all sorts of trouble there. That sounds fun. Is this the only brace... Yeah, I could do that. Might not work. There we
go. Come on, I don't want to stick around here long.
Yeah, I think it's interesting that I, you know, if I was in a...
Was that you?
If I'm busy, I don't cut my hair.
I have to keep my distance. Can't take any chances.
Oh, there. There's some scrap here.
Inquisitive type, eh?
Aye.
Stick close to me.
What?
I know how this works.
Hey, don't move.
Okay. We're not looking for trouble. Who are you?
I'm John. This is Ringo. They're just some assholes. We haven't got time for this. Come on, Jenna.
We're trying to get to comms. Can you help us?
We don't need their help. Don't tell them anything. Look, I've got the elevator working. Jenna, let's go, okay?
I'm sorry. Good luck.
Yeah. That's the last we see of you guys, I bet you.
What's that about? Why are you so damn aggressive?
Everyone's running shit scared. Keeping to their own. Safer that way.
Ooh. Guess that one's dead.
I hope this ship of yours is the real McCoy.
No, McCoy was on the Enterprise. This is the real...
Hold up. Let me get the elevator.
Ash. I guess Ash was the medical officer on the Nostromo.
Allow me. Place is old. Needs a special touch.
Okay.
Well, what are you waiting for? Hit the button.
Push the button. Don't hold back. I have to say, this space station really got a lot of paint shipments.
Right now.
Listen, darling. When we get to the ship, we can kick back, braid each other's hair, and chant all you want.
Yeah, when we get to my ship, I need to know what's going on. Right fucking now.
Fine. Like I said, there's a killer.
A killer?
A killer?
What does that mean?
I ain't seen it, but it's here. Picking us off one by one.
What are you saying? A psycho? A person?
No, something else. A monster.
Yeah, a monster that's behind you? I haven't played that in ages, I should. But actually, I need to get to bed. I got a hard week going on. Okay. Wow. You sure picked some dark places. to hang out. Watsume! Hold
shit.
Control.
Need to move. This way. Get down.
This is bullshit, man. You should be looking for a way off. Are you crazy? There's no way off. At least we're safe down here.
For how long? What if they come for us?
Then we shoot the crap out of them. Now shut up. You're making me nervous.
Okay.
Station feels like a graveyard, huh?
Great. Now what?
Trouble. We'll have to go random.
Great.
Follow me.
How convenient.
Glad I found you guys.
Okay.
Friends of yours?
I've had run-ins with those guys before. They don't like strangers. Even nice guys like me.
Are you a nice guy?
I'm pulling your chain, darling. You want to go and say hello? It's your funeral. Those guns aren't for show.
Someone should be doing something.
They are.
I'm just checking
it's
my back.
It's called surviving.
Everyone's turning on each other. The fear, it makes people crazy.
I've noticed.
Okay.
You've been living here?
What can I say? My butler's on holiday. Grab what you need. You don't know when you'll get another chance.
Okay, I'm looking for stuff. I found some scrap, is that all?
Some beer? Been hunkered down here for a week now, waiting for a ship. Waiting for you, I guess.
Oh, you've been reading about the android brain.
It can get dark around here. You should take that flashlight over there.
Where?
Make sure you're stocked up on batteries.
Flashlight. Excellent. Oh, it's nice that they actually have a flashlight that looks like it's a bit more modern. Considering everything else is, like, really low-tech.
Be careful not to flash it around. We don't want to get caught. Let's go.
Now, I'm going to save here. Just let me check in with the network here. Yes, I'm going to overwrite. So was there any... Did he... Oh, there.
This way.
Sign injector. Oh, give me a minute. I'm looking for stuff. Flashlight batteries. You see? Gotta find all these things. You guys are just, like, so impatient. Do you really want to get out there? I guess it's November. Oh, he's a guitarist. I'm not going to use the flashlight unless I absolutely have to.
What now?
I'll watch the vent. There's another vent right here somewhere. I marked it so I wouldn't forget it.
Oh. Guess I have to use my flashlight to look for things.
We're not going anywhere until you find that vent.
Okay, so... Oh, no. No, I don't need to do that. How do I use flashlight batteries? F. I'm holding F and it's my batteries are flashing. Oh, okay, I just tapped it instead of holding it.
This place gives me the willies.
There's not a vent. There's flashlight batteries, that's good to have. It's obviously a 1970s flashlight because it burns through batteries at an incredible rate.
Axel, is this it?
Hold on. I'm coming.
I wonder if there's any other stuff I've missed.
See? Got it covered.
Aye. Okay.
Come on.
I'm going. Okay. Gotta keep myself secret. Aye, I'm coming.
It's not smart to stay here too long.
Okay. I like how all the air ducts are big enough for people to walk through.
Is the way everyone travels around here?
Just those that want to stay alive, sweetheart.
Ah, good to know.
Torrance, so that's your ship, huh?
Yes, it is.
Quiet. I hear something.
So do I.
Yeah, I hear you. Will do. Gotta go meet the others. Something's going down.
There's always something going down.
Come on. We don't want to piss him off. This is some bullshit.
I like how the door opens near them when they walk past. And they don't... like it's ready to accept them.
Okay, gotta be quiet here. Don't shine that flashlight.
Ah, you get a gun there.
What's the emergency?
Someone else has been here. Everyone, stay alert. Keep your guns tight. Shoot anyone you don't know. Stick around while I check our stock.
There aren't too many of them to take on.
Take on?
We've still got to get through there. The door in the end.
How?
Let's try a distraction. The generator. That way. We'd have to check it out.
Find a way. Oh, I thought I was having to sneak here. Oh, what's this? There's a vent here.
You checked our supplies last.
I did. What's up?
You decide to help yourself a little?
What the fuck is that supposed to mean? Hey, he's been with me the whole time.
We're missing food, ammo, men. If it's not one
I have
of
no
us,
idea what I'm doing.
And we were right. Someone's been in here.
This is no good. We're supposed to be secure down here.
Damn it. What about the lockjaw rig?
I've just come from there. Sealed tight. Eyes open. Keep your guns ready.
Someone's gonna have to tell the boss.
Boss? He's a goddamn store clerk.
Yeah?
What is this?
You could do
better? Oh, there.
He's not saying that. Just...
It just turned itself off? No.
Somebody's here.
Check it out. Everyone with me.
I can hear them walking off to my left.
Who's there? Come out!
Doesn't seem to be broken.
How would you know, Einstein?
If the generator had blown, there'd be smoke.
This way.
Well,
ha! Let's keep it down. They're still close by. Follow me.
I'm going super, super quiet. Super, super quiet-like. Like a wee man. Oh, look! Gonna save my game. Because I'm so sure that I'm gonna die. Okay. Where now? We gonna go in here? Is that what you're saying? What? Why have you stopped outside here?
How much further?
Nearly there. Transit's just up ahead. Just hope your ship's still there. Sevastopol, not quite what you're expecting, eh?
No, it was not the vacation I wanted.
My shipping out papers were for a week ago.
Okay, is there anything in here? Both first shift and the two-man rule. You need two to open the door from two different consoles. Most of us don't know each other, so this is a safe. Okay. That's good to know. And then shared inventory. This is everything we've got. Okay, good to know. There's some door that needs two people to open. Come on, what now? Are we going this way? He was all like leading the way and now the scripting seems to have got a bit confused.
It's powered down. The assholes have cut us off. Got it. We need to activate both consoles at the same time to open it. I'll do this one. You go to the one on the other side.
Okay.
The other side on the other end of this cable? Jeez.
Ready.
One,
three. One, two, three.
Axel, behind you.
One.
No!
you! Get here now! I've got the thieving son of a bitch! You bums think you can take what you want? Get the fuck off me!
That's what we need. Oh, wow!
Fuck.
Let's go. The others are on their way. We need to go! Now!
Hey, you bastard!
Move it!
No, let's move fast! Run! I like how he just pauses there. Oh! Script to sequence!
You killed that guy!
Because he was going to kill me, you saved my life.
I have to admit, I like your logic.
It's about survival. Do you understand? Hear something.
Ooh, I hear chains.
I hear something.
Two chains.
Axel.
What have I got on me?
Oh, you get snot. That was really scary. Okay.
What's that thing?
Now wait, I came in that way, right? Should I go after the alien? Reach the transit station. I'm gonna keep going this way. Yeah, let's run this way. Transit station. Ah, here, green button. Hopefully it's not coming for me because I can't see a place to hide. Haven't quite learned that yet. Let's crouch. Oh, here it is. And there's an alien inside it ready to kill me. No! God, this door is so darn slow. And we're out of here. So let's actually just check to see how scary this is. I'll just go and bring up my heart rate as measured by my watch. Somewhere in here. There we go. Heart rate. Go on, check it. Just see how excited this has made me. Apparently it was 69 beats per minute a minute ago. So, yeah. That's not really very scary. Which door? Which door? Yeah, 67 now, so I'm actually more chill than I was a minute ago.
Station serving Seeks and Communication Technologies, tech support services, and Gemini Exoplanet Solutions.
Oh, there's a place to hide, that's good to know. Well, hopefully the alien doesn't know how to use, stuff. What do you call it? Hopefully the alien doesn't know how to use a transit system, otherwise I'm in trouble. I need a security access tuner, whatever that is. It's funny how I know that that's needed even though I don't have one. What's down this way? Oh look, there's one of these. I can open these doors. I can search his corpse for everything. And then remove that brace, why not? Go A. A, I'm pushing A. Holding R, press A, and it's going really slow.
Sorry for the current disruption in services.
Sorry? Oh, that's the rewire, okay. What I'm looking for is a save point, because I need to get some sleep. It's another rewire. I'm hoping... Yes! Emergency place. Okay! That's us! We gotta finish this up. Good night, everyone. think, yeah, Soma, I heard a lot of people asking me to play it, but I didn't download it before tonight's session, so we're gonna have to, you know, forego that for now. So anyway, yeah, I am gonna say farewell. Let's quit to the main menu. And I will perhaps play this some other time. Until then, I am Scott Manley. Oh, wait a second. I am Scott Manley. There was something I was going to say about flying safely flying without danger. I think I need some sleep. Good night, guys. Fly safe.